The World Food Program is the UN's frontline agency for fighting global hunger, and right now it has its hands especially full with four major food emergencies at once. In Syria, with millions displaced and in refugee camps, in the Central African Republic, another conflict area where the UN has warned of potential famine, in neighboring South Sudan, in the news recently with an outbreak of factional and tribal violence, and in the Philippines, still reeling from Typhoon Haiyan. The World Food Program is based in Rome. Its executive director is Ertharin Cousin, an American with many years of experience in food issues in the nonprofit, corporate, and government sectors. And she joins us now, and welcome to you.
Thank you so much.
First, the sheer number of emergency situations. How unusual and what kind of challenges is it to deal with them all at once?
Well, needless to say, it is highly unusual. When we created this category of level three emergencies, which the UN and the nonprofit community work together globally to ensure that we meet the needs of those who are impacted by the most serious emergencies, we all said, what would we do if we had three of them? And now we have four.
It's notable that three of the four are conflict areas.
Yes.
Civil war, a lot of violence.
Yes.
What kind of challenges does that pose in particular?
Well, needless to say, in conflict areas, the challenge is that you have war and mm-hmm. you have the inability to access those who are in what we call besieged areas or areas where fighting is ongoing, because it's very difficult for humanitarians to access those areas mm-hmm. to assist the victims of the conflict.
So take an example of the Central African Republic, one that doesn't get that much attention. What are you doing? What are you able to do? What are you not able to do?
In the Central African Republic, we fed over 300,000 people in Bangui itself, as well as in Bosengoa and the areas in the rural areas of the Central African Republic. Mm-hmm. But the challenge is there are a lot more people who are in need of assistance that we can't get access to. And a good example of that is that there are 100,000 people in and around the airport itself in Bangui. When we began a feeding program in that area, our humanitarian workers were attacked. Mm. And so we had to stop the feeding program.
So the food is there, but you just can't get it.
Get it to people because of the ongoing violence in the area.
You know, we talk about these crises, but in the meantime, there's so much more, I know. And I was just reading today about the continuing problem that you're dealing with in Kenya, in refugee camps. And I saw where you wrote, the world's gaze has turned elsewhere. Now, this must happen constantly for you, right?
Yeah. It does. And it's tragic because you feel as if you're prioritizing one hungry child over another.
You feel that personally?
I feel that personally because in Kenya and Dadaab, where you have Somali refugees, there's still over 500,000 people in the Dadaab refugee camps. And we had to cut rations there, first 10% in December and another 10% in January. That means that there are children there that are not going to get the nutritious food that they need.
You've been at this in many different ways for a long time. When does the world pay attention and when does it not? And when do you get frustrated and when do you not?
Unfortunately, the world pays attention when the media shines a light on those in need, which is why it's so important that we maintain the global public will that is necessary to meet the needs of those we serve. We require investments. The WFP is 100% voluntarily funded, and we depend upon the generosity of governments from around the world, like the United States, where we receive significant support for our work. But we recognize that there's only so many dollars to go around, and what it forces us to do is, when I get frustrated, is when I see a situation where we know we can make a difference, but we don't have the resources to support those in need.
And that happens?
Too often.
Too often. Setting aside the immediate crises that we're talking about, if you can, for a moment, when you think about the longer-term issues of food security around the world, because I know there's another area for you, is just how do people feed themselves?
Yes.
How does the world feed itself? Crises aside, what do you think, what do we need to know, or what is not happening that you'd like to see happen?
Well, the solutions are available to us. We recognize that the majority of people who are food insecure or hungry in the world live in rural areas, and most of them are smallholder subsistence farmers. By increasing the development of the agricultural chain, the agricultural marketing chain in countries where we serve. Mm-hmm. We can provide the economic support necessary to those smallholders so that they can feed their families in a sustainable and durable manner. Mm-hmm. So we know what's required. The challenge is it's not a one-year solution. Mm-hmm. It's going to require multi-year implementation of the work that is necessary to support the smallholder farmers so that they can ultimately feed themselves and feed their children, and our support is no longer necessary. And we know it works, because China's a great example. Mm-hmm. 50 years ago when WFP was started, China was our largest country program. We mm-hmm. worked to support smallholder farmers in mm-hmm. China and began to make a difference there, and we know where China is today.
All right. Ertharin Cousin is Executive Director of the World Food Program. Thanks so much.
Thank you for having me.